Okay, here we go. I'm Holger Voss, also known as Space Holger. So I will talk a little bit about ideas that could be used to boosting the space topic into the public, for the public a little bit more. It's mainly about STEM, but not only. Okay, personal background. Actually, I'm an astrophysicist. I worked for the exoplanet search mission Corot at DLR, actually, and now I'm working for the Gaia ESA mission as a payload expert and for calibration aspects at the University of Barcelona. I'm also doing a little bit public outreach. And, well, additionally to that, I'm a space geek for my entire life already, so, and the main event that is responsible for that, we saw that in the talk before, was the first space shuttle launch in 1981, actually, so, and so I was really impressed by that one, and also by the landing, so, so I went to a shuttle launch a few years ago, and that's really something really, really awful. Awesome. Really, really impressive. So I will go soon to Florida again for another launch, for sure. As I said, really, really impressive. And almost every space mission is beginning with a launch, actually. And well, for many of the missions, the launch is the most impressive event for the public. But we have an issue here in Europe. There are no launches. Accessible for the public, so no space launches at least. There's the Sounding rockets and be launched in Sweden, but well, space launches are not accessible. But we may have a small alternative, especially I think that's good for the kids to learn something about space. You can build a lot of model rockets that look like the real space launchers, a little bit smaller actually, so as I do, and then I launch them. So, but these generations of scientists and astronauts were inspired by this. Do you recognize this guy actually, anyone? Exactly. And also Alexander Gerst loves this topic. This is in a recent image from December with one of my rockets that is now located in his flat in Köln, actually. So during the recent years, I did launches dedicated to some real space missions for the ATV 5 and 4, actually, and also for the mission I'm working on for Gaia. So for the Ariane 5, you can see, for instance, that I also experiment with launch towers and things like that to make it a little bit more realistic. And actually, that works quite fine. So, okay. The latest example is the mini IXV mission that I launched in January. This very special mission, I was able to conduct the entire mission, more or less, a little bit in 30 seconds instead of the 100 minutes of the real mission. So the IXV was really included into the payload fairing, was released and landing on its own parachute. So I think it's quite a nice flight on working on the first time. So I also did some dedicated launches to the human spaceflight mission for Alexander Gerst, Blue Dot mission, also for Samantha. So these videos are published on the blogs of Alexander Gerst, and also Samantha published that HuffPost for 2, for instance, and well. So I can build any launcher actually as a model, so different sizes. I could put instruments like cameras or altimeters on it, and well, I also built the old obsolete version of the Ariane 6. Actually, it's a two-stage rocket, so three motors in the first stage and the same motor in the second stage, and it was quite impressive, the flight. Well, I also have a flying space shuttle model, actually, so, but that's the past. Let's go to the future, the SLS with an Orion and the European service module on top. Well, but these rockets you can use for several purposes. For instance, I used it for the kickoff meeting of the ESA M3 Plato mission in Berlin last summer. So launching a small Soyuz launcher there in the field near the DLR. Well, and I think also the ESA launchers would need a little bit more public outreach. And well, you can dream, you can build your mini Kourou with including all the launch pads and towers and things like that. So and that could be transported to any place in Europe to do a launch, actually, or do a live transmission of a launch. So, and well, but if the main application I'm thinking of is actually to go into schools to do launches for school kids. So in the age of maybe 7, 8, 9. So you can really impress this, the school kids with that. So, and you can also add additional content showing videos about Rosetta, about the flights to the ISS, so building paper models and things like that. So I did that during my holidays in September last year, and everybody had a lot of fun, including myself. So I will do that again for sure. And we have developed during the recent month with some friends a nice idea, I think. Do you know this character, the mouse? It's more the German thing, I think. So it's not so really well known in enter Europe or anyone outside of Germany, no. Okay, well, actually, this mouse is a frequent space flyer already. It was in orbit with Alexander Gerst last year, but also in 1992 already. So, well, it's, as I said, an experienced space flyer. But now, until the next mission of a German astronaut, it will have to wait, oh, maybe 10 years. So, but we think, we were thinking that start to continue the mission of the mouse to go to an exploration flight. So 2 days ago, actually, we had the first launch. So near Bonn, which faster, and the mouse did its first suborbital solo flight during the solar eclipse in the fog, actually, so but we could not see the sun, but it was very, very impressive, and we will have more launches in the future of the mouse into space. There are a lot of things planned, actually. I'm constructing already a much larger launcher, where you have a much more realistic spaceship that looks a little bit like the Orion spacecraft. And actually, we are not only thinking on launching the mouse and the rocket, but also to build models for in space simulations, let's say. And we can go anywhere with the mouse, actually, Mars, asteroids, or even the comet, for instance, 67P, visiting Philae, is an idea. And well, we can build anything of future space hardware as a model and fly the mouse to any place. And we can have guest astronauts, for instance, like Pakshi. And I think, well, it's a nice idea, and we will continue with that. So, and well, in the main idea is to inspire kids, actually, to have more events like that one.
Wow, was für ein schöner Flug!
okay. That is, so the idea is to expand this a little bit, but I'm looking for some kind of ideas how this can be supported, because the schools cannot pay for this service, actually, let's say. So, but I have talked with several people already, so there are some ideas. If you have any ideas, suggestions, please let me know. And, well, thanks for your attention. Any questions? Time left for questions? No, no. Well, a few hundred meters, but you can scale the desired high with using different type of motors, actually. So you need an area of maybe half a football field at least, so to be on the safe side. When the rocket is landing on a parachute, so it's drifting with the wind. There are solid rocket motors in it. So it's, you could call it enhanced fireworks if you want, but I don't do that.
Any other question? Well, actually, I had one. You launched this rocket in schools. How many schools already had the opportunity to see that? And how do you get in contact with those schools?
Well, I have many friends. They have children. So, and actually, I started this thing to do for private events for them. So, and they were telling it in the schools, and then I'm getting some invitations, actually, so that's how it works. So mainly, I'm originally from Berlin, so mainly it's in the Berlin area so far.
Thank you. Any other questions? I think we are pretty much on time. So thank you very much for your talk.